Holy shit. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Assurrect Andromeda. Oh, there we go. There's the ambient noise. It hadn't loaded in when I started the game. I thought something was broken. I thought it was broken, guys. Could have been broken. Okay. Anyways. So, yeah, we were down here. We left off. I stopped the recording a little bit early.
Report from the Nexus. Population's growing as people wake up. Lots of hopefuls waiting for a home.
Bradley will have all the help he can take.
That's a lot of sex.
They'll be starting crops soon.
I didn't mean to cut her off there, but I didn't know it was...
Can't tell if they have enough water or too much.
Huh? Can you have too much water?
I grew up on a little cargo freighter. Only saw gardens in vids. But I always loved them. I... daydreamed about planting a big rose garden when we got here and still imagine it sometimes. Roses in Helios.
Let's get everyone fed before we start flower gardens.
Fair. But everyone around here has dreams. I didn't for a while. After I left the Asari Commandos, well, I didn't leave. My mentor, Nasira, said I should go.
Why?
The initiative would suit you better, was all she said. Being a huntress suited me fine, but she insisted.
It sounds like she cared more about what you needed than about what you wanted.
I didn't need to be rejected. Still, that's familiar. When your biotics are honed into huntress-grade weapons, people can be weird about it. The initiative seemed better. Just didn't see how I'd fit into their brave new galaxy. I never fit anywhere before. Then I met some jerk named Ryder. Talked about traveling to Andromeda like he was teaching you how to see it.
What part of that vision made you want to take the plunge?
A civilization where everyone had a place. Even AI. Or an overpowered human biotic. Your father said, I get being different. Now imagine being welcome and making others like you welcome too. When I was 13, I could warp a steel girder. He made me wonder, what if someone had told me that's okay?
He gave you a dream to work toward. He was good at that.
Who doesn't want to belong? Especially somewhere like the Initiative. So I gave the Initiative my all. Kept thinking of the niche I wanted.
Oh god. Garden. She's one of those English people that says niche instead of niche.
This is about not taking over as Pathfinder?
Didn't think it would still sting. Nasira, your father, even my parents. They leave, I'm left without answers. Nowhere to stand.
None.
I get that. We've all had a lot of disappointments lately.
You're doing well. For having no training, being your second isn't so bad. And if that remnant tech pays off, maybe someday I'll have roses, too.
Roses. Roses. Look at all the little flowery plants. Like, what are those? Blue things? And what's in here? Weed? Some green stuff? That's about all that's in here at the moment. I'll talk to her again here in a minute to see if she's got anything else to say. But I believe we were out here. In fact, I'm sure that our strike team... completed. Delay ship launches. Nicey shit nugget. Space. To debrief. 11,400 XP. Mission rewards, 5 funds, and a whole bunch of loot. Let's go to my loot, because we gotta open up that loot. It says credit loot box. We got some free credits. That's cool beans. Material loot box. Fucking copper. I don't want that. I need beryllium. Dude. Okay, let's see. Where does that... Yeah, they're level 6 now, huh? Goodness gracious. I see the silver ones are probably going to be harder, huh? Delay ship. Watch me fail it. I go 270-something percents and I beat them both. And now the 87% one's gonna lose. Did we talk to Lexi? I don't think so.
So we have a stowaway.
You mean PB?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods. You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality. Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
Why do you sort them that way?
Just easier for me to see patterns in behavior.
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
Gil?
Gil likes to use humor as a defensive technique. He'd rather bury himself in the Nomad than tackle emotions head on.
How's Cora doing?
She's processing. Your father was her mentor. She expected to follow in his footsteps, but he gave the role of Pathfinder to you. Just because she trusts his judgment doesn't mean she's not confused. Or hurt.
That's noticeable.
Sylvie okay?
She's remarkably adaptive. I'm kind of jealous.
How's Liam?
A handful. Every time I patch him up, he breaks something new. Liam's we can't lose attitude is commendable. But I worry how he'll react when something does go wrong.
I'd like to check in on the non-human crew.
Ask away.
Is PB all right?
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
Okay. I mean, fair enough, but still, she didn't deny it.
Is Drac good?
That old bastard's always good. I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Yeah, holy shit, like, Drac has some frickin'... He's not like the normal, like, what I'd expect from a Krogan crew member.
Don't worry, Lexi. I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you. And maybe don't mention I asked?
How's our Solarian?
He's quite the gossip. Tight-lipped about himself, though.
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her. I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
Thanks for the insight. How did you get into medicine?
My mom was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights. Discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Yeah, I know we already talked to them. Let's go see Cora quick. Wait, hold on. Sorry, I had to itch myself. Cause I don't know if Cora's got anything else to say that. Oh, here we go.
Hi there.
How's the search for the Asari Ark going?
The Lucinia? Checking every comm that's coming in. Nothing concrete yet.
Any more commando war stories?
We once infiltrated a dangerous cult by posing as new initiates. Belenza hated it. She was like our padre. The cult, that perversion of faith, really upset her.
How did you stop them?
Nasira pretended that Belenza needed to be purified of evil. She was given a private audience with the cult leader. Belenza shot her. And then prayed for her.
Any more commando war stories?
Not just now. I'll try to remember a good one.
See you later, Cora.
Okay, I'll be here.
Lastly, I don't think we checked in with PB or the bridge.
Where's my data pad? Oh, how'd you get under there?
Tsuvi, were you talking to your notebook?
Oh, I was, wasn't I? I do that sometimes.
Okay. It's okay. I talk to myself all the time. I also talk to my pillow. But we won't talk
about
that.
You're setting up in here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Should I consider you a temporary addition?
Everything's temporary, Ryder. I get it. What? You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that? Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field, while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
Oh, I ain't about to romance you, that's for sure. There's only one Asari in this universe that's worth my time. Boredom? Okay. Fuck, I don't know.
You left everything and everyone you knew because you were bored?
No. I came with someone I knew.
Oh.
Then she got bored with me. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that.
Well, no.
Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown.
If you would have...
for the never been done.
If you would have stayed for a couple more years, there would have been some new shit to experience. Like anal rectifying red laser beams.
Well, congratulate yourself. No one has ever so successfully dodged my attempts to get to know them.
Yes! I'm number one! Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth.
It what?
Then again, I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned, which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
Seems kind of rare, but okay.
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
You really won't tell me what you're working on?
That's right. Next question.
Okay, that was fast.
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Well, I wasn't supposed to be woken up yet. A resourceful accomplice finagled my early thaw. So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin, I started, borrowing shuttles. After that,
borrowing.
I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
So, how do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Vetra. Not your typical military-minded Turian. Liam seems a lively one. I expect he'll surprise me. Drek is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
What about...
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Callow and Suvi seem busy. Hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right, Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
She's exactly what she should be. Capable, reliable. She's a valuable part of my team.
Sure, sure. That comes across too.
There's also Lexi, our doctor. She's an Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
I'll get around to her.
What drew you to the remnant?
Are you kidding? It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that. There's so much to discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech, it's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone.
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. The one who woke me up early. But now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
You're off the hook, PB. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
She's in the escape pod with a whole bunch of fucking this shit. What the hell happens if we need to abandon ship and we all come running through here and start tripping over your shit and somebody smashes their face into the wall over there and knocks themselves out? What do you get, PB? You could get people killed.
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
Am I the only one that finds Suvi kind of cute? I don't know about that.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
You mean a god?
Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd.
It's a little odd.
I'm a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
Dude! Now, the decision I pick here is going to determine how many dislikes I get on this video.
There's something about coming face to face with something wondrous that makes you want to believe.
Wow. It's wonderful to meet someone who understands. I've had to justify myself so often, as if having faith in the divine invalidated my work as a scientist. As if this sacred could be diminished by the search for truth.
You could romance her? Oh, I'm okay with that.
It's good to have different voices on my team. I like that.
Excellent. Oh, speaking of the team, I should update the folks back in the Nexus with the latest reports. We'll talk later.
Oh, shit. This gave me a... Never mind. And last but not least, our captain.
Hello, Gil.
Or our pilot.
When are you cleaning up that repair on the sensor console?
I'm not. It's a redesign.
A redesign? Without a trained crew?
I'm trained, and it's working great.
Holy shit.
Don't be so uptight.
Everything okay?
Oh, fine. Fine. Don't worry about it.
They've got fucking eyeballs. Like, little slits where their pupils would be. I've just never noticed that about a Solarian, because their eyes are so black, but from the reflection from the planet, or the sun, I guess, or the star, or whatever, whatever's reflecting out there, you could see very, very slightly the detail in his eyeballs.
What can I do for you?
What can I do you for?
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Well, I can't talk about Suvi. She's sitting right there.
I'm not listening. You can say whatever you like.
Oh no, I'm not falling for that again.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
I'll admit it, Gil's rather irritating. He insists on redesigning systems rather than maintaining them.
He likes to do things his way.
That doesn't make it the right way.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Liam's quite fun. Not many humans have that kind of energy. I probably shouldn't have told him there are secret compartments in the armory, though. He's been looking all day.
Well, I would too.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Dr. Tapero seems nice, if quiet. It must be very different here, compared to the Hyperion. Fewer people in stasis shock.
Let's keep it that way. What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Given Drak's history with Solarians, it's probably better I just stay out of his way. Too bad. That grunion roast he makes smells delicious.
You're gonna make me hungry. I ate 3 slices of bread this morning when I woke up. Well, it's... what time is it? It's 5:20 a.m. I ate like 3 slices of bread at 4 in the morning. And I was like, delicious.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
I like PB. But I really hope she doesn't lean on the escape pod's manual release by accident.
Is that easy to do?
It's an escape pod. If it's difficult to use, you're doing it wrong.
Well, now I'm worried.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Vetra's very kind. She actually got hold of some dried seaweed snacks for me.
Ooh.
Said I needed feeding up.
Yeah, dried seaweed. Because, you know, that's really going to give you some meat on your bones.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
I don't talk to Cora much. She always seems so busy. There are things I'd like to ask her about your father, but it never seems like a good time.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
No, if I gossip anymore, I'll get in trouble.
Oh, okay.
Tell me something else about the ship.
O'Connell, our systems designer, was running a power distribution model. How power moves through the ship. But he forgot to lock his terminal and we, added a few embellishments. For 2 days, poor O'Connell was convinced that turning on all the bathroom lights would overload the engine core.
Yeah, so he's repeating himself from earlier, I think.
I couldn't help overhearing you and Gil. Sounded pretty heated.
He likes redesigning things, but the ship was built this way for a reason. I wish Gil would respect that. It's nothing to concern yourself about, really.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
Okay. And that's the galaxy map. What the hell? Oh, a mail turned to me. Spirituality. From Suvi. Dear writer, I'm so glad for our chat earlier. I just sent this email from 10 feet away from where you were standing, merely 5 minutes after we talked. Oh, I've had to defend what I believe so often that I have to admit, I'm a little tired of it. Whenever I meet someone who feels the same, or just understands, I really appreciate it. So thank you. You're welcome, Suvi. Why don't you just be one of my own souvenirs? What the hell is going on? Loadout station? We don't need to load out right now. Okay. So let me run Barack Obama. Because I want to see... Research. Development. Guns. Sniper rifles. And then Black Widow. We need this beryllium. Where do you find beryllium? Because we need it. We need it now. We need it right now. What does it say, actually? Like, if I click View Required Materials? Beryllium can be detected via orbital scan and mined with the Nomad. It can also be purchased from certain merchants. Okay. Well, there's still a little bit of the galaxy map that we haven't explored. Because we came to the EOS system first. So let's run, because I don't know if there might be any, like, beryllium stuff in any of the orbits or asteroids. Otherwise, we're going back to the Nexus. What is that? Oh, probably to re-land, huh? Yeah, see, available minerals. Ain't no beryllium here. How do you... System view, here we go.
Anomaly detected.
Oh, an anomalous.
Probe.
Holy shit, it's been a long time
tracking
since we did this.
A huge mineral deposit.
Better be beryllium. Better be 120 beryllium, specifically. Fucking iron.
Up something.
Oh, you mean this giant splotch of blackness?
Probes launched.
Better be beryllium.
Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Shit! It ain't enough. Go to Nanook. And then I think after we're done scanning this system, we're gonna have to head back to the Nexus, because there's some things we gotta turn in. That's a really nice looking gas giant. I mean, it's really pretty looking. It's like it's ripped straight from Elite Dangerous. It's a hydrogen methane gas giant. Debris. Kept visitors, huh? nothing to find here. Well, Tigerfrost, you can skip these cutscenes, you know. Yeah, I could. Look at this little lonely motherfucker floating out here. Holy shit, it's Earth. Actually, it looks icy.
Anomaly detected.
An anomalous. Chlorine, this indicates primitive chlorine-based life. However, no detailed study has been completed. Oh, it's floating, then it ain't beryllium.
Probes launched. Satellite detected.
Is that one of ours? Scientific monitoring satellite launched by an early explorer to Eos. This mission was abandoned when the original settlement of Eos failed. Oh. Has been gathered valuable data. Like what? Milky Way research data. Well, that's great. Could they have, like, some beryllium on board? Because that would be even better. Man, it's freaking cold. Might need to grab my other blanket to help. Something tells me that's not a city. Shit, it's Earth after the Reaper attack. Again. Tidal heating and bombardment from Pethys' asteroid belt has aggravated Pele's volcanic activity. Yeah, here, looking at that Pele, or Pele, I guess, I don't know, reminds me of Peleliu, which is hilarious, because I've heard so many different pronunciations of Peleliu that it's fucking ridiculous. You've got Peleliu, right, which is just how I grew up knowing it, then you've got the Mighty Jingle saying Peleliui, and then you've got Tom Hanks saying Peleliu, so I don't know what the fuck. That's a pretty looking planet. I mean, it's shit, but it's a pretty shit planet. Just so you know, it's a satellite's attract debris. There's nothing else. Damn. Well, we finally found our first piece of beryllium at the very least. 72 of it, but that ain't enough, damn it. That just ain't enough. So yeah, we gotta go back to the Nexus. So it doesn't even let us go to the new vault location yet. Fair enough.
Ah, familiar territory.
The Nexus has been here for months. Still not enough time to survey all.
I surveyed all of it. Realize we were over top a giant gas giant. A giant gas giant. What the hell is all this? Are those all the things I gotta do here? Holy frick nugget. Yeah, we got that murder thing to quest mission to turn in. Ow, my freaking knee hole! What the hell?
Pathfinder, is it true?
Whoa.
We're settling Eos.
Yes.
We've thought that before.
But Eos is different now, right? Pathfinder.
Alright, settle down. Give him space.
Lieutenant Syak's Kendros' aide. They all wanted to see you. Real hope again. It's been a while.
Relax, Lieutenant. If there was ever a day to pop some champagne.
Certainly. The initiative's finally back on track.
Professor Herrick, right?
What you achieve with that remnant vault is unprecedented, Pathfinder. Impossible.
With more military personnel out of stasis, those Ket won't get near your vault. Or our people.
We've taken some hard knocks, but this proves we'll always get up again.
Always.
Well, what are you waiting for? There's a new world out there.
Thank you, Ryder.
You're very welcome, Mr. Solarian.
Watch your tone. You saw what happened to the Krogan.
But we need this equipment.
What?
Well, you're not getting it. Stop making frivolous requests.
It's not a frivolous request. Properly functioning air filters are
Frivolous. You'll just have to make do.
That's Spender.
We can't fix the station breathing bad air.
Your incompetence isn't my problem. Just do your job.
What do you want?
What do you want?
Whatever's going on, it's not fair to take it out on me.
Apologies, you're right. This is not your fault.
I haven't heard much good about that guy.
Whatever you've heard, it's not half as bad as the reality. Just last week, he tried to redirect some of the supplies we need to keep the stasis pods going.
Why?
I have no idea, but if Kesh hadn't stepped in and threatened to airlock him, it would have been a disaster. He's always like that, making bad decisions, driving the Krogan away, treating people like scum when no one's watching.
Maybe there's something I can do.
A man like that's bound to have some dirt. I wish Tan and Addison could see it. Things have gotten so bad that Kesh had to literally kick him out of engineering.
How literal are we talking here?
Boot to ass. Oh, it was glorious. We need him gone, but as incompetent as Spender is at his job, he's insanely good at keeping it. Kesh can tell you more.